I've been over here at my brother Dan's, a.k.a. Danimal, a.k.a. Funboy, the last few days, living up kind of the Main Street area. It's a little easier to get some of my medical appointments. But the thing I really like about his house is when I moved to a small apartment, I had to find homes for a lot of my art. And the things that are very personal to me are my static montages. And when I came over for Canadian Thanksgiving, Dan had the whole house done up like a little gallery with all my work. So there's the one here from Belize. And what these are, I call them storyboards or static montages, but I take all the little ephemeral bits that you collect when traveling and collage them together. I only take a, like a little disposable single-use underwater camera on each trip, so it's just a few scanned photos. This one, that first one was from Belize, specifically on Key Cocker, a small island on Belize. And there's bigger pictures of these online. And then this one, part of my crappy camera work, is from Amsterdam when I was there in 2002. I've been there a number of times. But I put, this one has layers on top of layers on top of layers to blend all the nuance and the adventures together. There's also a couple rock and roll posters that are worth seeing down here that are just awaiting framing. My secret calling in life, I think, was to be a picture framer. There's the Guess Who running across, back across Canada. The 100 Pipers mirror. This is Grateful Dead in Vancouver, a Bob Massey print in 1967. Or 66 rather. And there is the Dead and Doobies and a bunch of other bands at the Gorge a while back. Oh, and then right up here with me is another one of my collage static montage. So one of the inspirations came here in Palau. This is all artifacts from Palau. And they do these relief carvings called storyboards. And I kind of like the idea of having this three-dimensional story. And you'll notice in these, like, I blend in text and little notes around, so the story can be kind of self-encapsulated in a certain manner. Now, it's also worth noting that all of these are done on different substrates or surfaces or whatever. I just kind of take whatever's handy. This one here is from Brother Dan and I's adventure at the 2002 Olympics in Salt Lake City. And we finally got this done. It took us about 10, 12 years of waiting, but we got it done. And this one actually is on a big canvas, and it's a lot of weight for that canvas to support and not have stuff sagging. But we managed to do it with all these tickets, all these certificates, all this neat stuff. And it was quite a challenge just going through all this stuff to decide what makes the cut.
Well, there's just one flaw, David. That was we did it upside down.
But that's what we call professionals. But it is signed by Mitt Romney right there. Mitt Romney and Ross Rebliotti. So I think we get bonus points for that. All right, now here in Dan's front room, we have some of his scarf collection. Poster from the Further Festival, which was a very important post-Jerry event. And then another one of my works, which is, this is a collection of buses, as you can see. I hope you can see. I love Volkswagen buses. And pictures of them, the dreams of them, because they all have such stories and names. But this is a collage of buses I've loved and owned. And then this one here is maybe the first of these little storyboards I made. And this I made for Dan's birthday, and it's to celebrate his first Grateful Dead show. So it's an unripped ticket to his first show, and then a few of these fuzzy pictures. A patch that was on a pair of shorts that Marty Kendall and Brother Bob and I all wore at different times. I hope we washed him in between that. And then the set list typed out there. And this was all reverse mat cut. So much trickier than I usually do. Finally, here's a few other great framed objects. This is a Jay Pollock printed on hemp paper. Some guy used to live in Vancouver. Some more Grateful Dead benefits. This is the Grateful Dead's last summer tour. It's a great fish poster by same Jay Pollock. Cascadia flag, and then for the finale, let me see if I can get you a good shot of this. This is the banner, the backdrop for the band at Uncle Weed 42, Danimal 39. And this was all handmade, of course, with giant cutouts and spray paints and stencils and tie-dye cloth for planets. And that's on heavy-duty Polish hemp, so that's a beauty that will outlive us all. But I particularly like the little campground. Because camping brings me happiness. Would you consider coming camping in this campsite with me? All right, thanks for letting me show you around the Danimal East Side Gallery.